Hey guys, remember the series premiere of the new Netflix series, 13 Reasons Why. This is Season 1, Episode 1, Tape A, Side 1, and I definitely was looking forward to this show, even though, unlike other Netflix shows, I really didn't know much going into it. Most Netflix shows, you know, I know a lot about. I try to get as much access to them as I can. This was a show, however, that I really did not know what the show was really going to be. I didn't watch the first trailer, and I tried to stay away from it. I wanted to go into the show kind of blind. It looked like something different than stuff Netflix has done before, and after watching this first episode, I can honestly say that a lot of people haven't been talking about the show. Like, I haven't heard a lot of people talk about the show, but this show is pretty great. I really did love this first episode. I thought it was definitely very well done. It's not perfect. I don't think this is a perfect show or anything, but it's definitely a lot better than I think it could have been, because the plot of this show doesn't exactly sound like something that would work. The plot, essentially, this girl, Hannah Baker, we find on the very beginning of the show, it's not a spoiler, she has committed suicide, and it's not a spoiler, because like I said, it's the plot of the show. But basically, that is obviously on everyone's minds at this school. You know, she had a few allies and, you know, friends, things like that were close to her. But in the midst of all this is this kid, Clay. Now, Clay is someone who, he's nerdy, and he is well-respected at the school for it. You know, people don't really bully him, but he definitely is very affected by Hannah's death. And there are these tapes, basically, that are being passed around to different people, and Clay finds out that, basically, there are 13 people in Hannah's life that she says are the 13 reasons why she died, and she categorizes those 13 people as the 13 reasons. And Clay finds out he is actually one of those reasons, and desperate to find out why, he seeks out the tapes and basically starts listening to her story. And that's basically all I'm gonna say. That's basically all we get in this first episode, but let's just get into this first episode, starting off with the cast. And when it comes to a show like this that is quite heavy and really wants you to care about these characters, especially someone who has died, it really does rely on the cast. And luckily, Netflix did a great job at getting very, very talented actors here. I think everyone really did do a great job in this first episode. I don't really think there was anyone that was really bad. Well, maybe only one that I didn't think was that great, but she's not going to be a big part of the show in general, so I don't really have too much to say about her. Let's first talk about Dylan Minnette as our main character, Clay. Dylan Minnette, of course, is probably the most well-known out of any of the actors here. He did a really good job. I really liked his character in this first episode. This character, Clay, like I said, he's someone who, he's nerdy, and he definitely is a bit eccentric, but he's not necessarily bullied for it. Like, people know who he is, they know he's different, but they respect him for it, and he's, you know, normal enough that he's able to get by in school, and I really did like that with his character. I thought definitely he did a very good job with that, but you can tell he's definitely hurting over what he did with Hannah, and there's a lot of really great stuff with this character, just relenting and realizing that certain conversations that he had with her actually were much more integral than he thought they were, and the way that he interprets things is differently now, and just all of that I thought was definitely very well done. He really did a great job in this first episode. I really do like his character as a whole. I thought he definitely was very good. My only thing is, we don't really know a ton about him right now. I was expecting to learn a little bit more about Clay as the episode went on, and we know basically as much as we did before it went into the show, that, you know, he's a nerd, he was friends with Hannah, and that's about it. And I'm hoping we get more into his character as the show goes on, because he is our main character, and I definitely care about him, and they give you definitely enough reasons to care about his character, but I just want to find out more about him. I liked him overall. I think Dylan Minnette's a very good actor, but I just hope they give us more with Clay as the show goes on. However, easily the star of the show, without a doubt, is Katherine Langford as Hannah Baker, who is fantastic in this role. I think she was perfectly casted in this role as Hannah. Not only is Hannah, I think, the best character on the show, but she's definitely the most sympathetic. Like, when this is going on, you know that Hannah has committed suicide, but you can really see the journey that has led her up to that. And her story in general, I definitely found myself very invested in. I'm definitely interested in seeing where she's really gonna go. She's someone who is very She's very specific of what she does. She doesn't go to a lot of parties. She doesn't hang out with a lot of people. She's very picky with who she hangs out with. She has definitely a very interesting taste in people and things like that. And I really did like her character as a whole. I thought she definitely did a very good job. I really liked the way they set up, you know, where her character was going. Her and Clay's friendship, I think, was definitely one of the high points of this first episode. So you can understand why these two would be friends, why she would take such an interest in him. And you can see that Clay, over time, really started to like her, and the second he saw her, he really did have this crush on her, and he's grief-stricken because, but the one girl that he really liked is gone, and you really do see that connection that these two had, and how tragic that friendship really is gonna lead. It's definitely sad to see, but I think they portrayed it quite well here. I really did love their overall friendship. I think they handled it very well here. Like I said, there's so much that Hannah's going through. Right now, she seems to have, you know, a fine life. You know, she has a couple friends here and there. She doesn't really have many friends, but she definitely does have a couple friends. But there's this guy that she really did like, and I thought overall her story was definitely very well. And I'm very interested in seeing where she's gonna go, and they definitely did pick the right girl. I like they picked an unknown because I feel like if they didn't, we'd judge her based on previous works. But this actress, to my knowledge, has never really done anything else, and I really like what she did here. I thought overall she did a very good performance, and I can't wait to see where she ends up going within future episodes. It's, you know, crazy to say that I'm not ex you know that I'm looking forward to seeing how she commits suicide. That's not what I'm saying, but I am definitely interested in seeing where her character ends up going throughout the show because she easily is the most interesting character out of everyone. And then the rest of the characters on the show are fine, but we don't really get that much with them. There are really only two other central characters in this first episode to really talk about. First of all, Christian Navarro plays Tony, who is kind of Clay's friend, kind of not, but he's the one who had the tapes at his house, and he's definitely listened to them before. Like, we definitely know at the end of this episode that he's listened to the tapes before, and he definitely knows more about Hannah's story, so I'm interested in getting more into his character. We don't know a ton about him, but I liked his point. Thought he definitely did a good job. But the other character to talk about is Brandon Flynn as Justin, because Justin's this guy that Hannah likes in this first episode. Really, the first guy she ever liked. He was her first kiss. He was her first crush. And it ended up going terribly. And I thought overall, their relation in this first episode really is my only complaints. While I did like the way things were done, one, I thought their friendship was incredibly rushed. We didn't really get to see a ton of progression. It kind of just went from her liking him to immediately they're on their first date. And I get it that it definitely took them, you know, they tried not to rush it. You know, they were trying to just get to the story because obviously this girl's already died. But I want to see more there, and a lot of their moments, it did feel a little bit phoned in, just a little bit cheesy, but as a whole, I did like their chemistry. I thought they worked quite well. Some of it was a bit forced, like definitely there's some of the lines there and some of the things that happened I thought was a little bit cheesy, but their story, I like Justin as a character. You can tell what Justin did. What happened with Hannah was definitely not his fault, because I'm just gonna spoil it right now. If you guys don't want no minor spoilers here, because it's a big deal in the first episode, but it's not like the biggest spoiler ever. Basically, Hannah and Justin went on a first date. Everything went fine, except Justin took an upskirt picture of her, and through him taking this picture, he showed it off to his friends, and needless to say, his friends got a hold of it, and well, you can imagine what ended up going there. That kind of set the tone for where Hannah's gonna go. But they did do a good job with showing why Hannah's gonna go on this dark path and what's gonna happen between her and Justin. I thought overall he definitely did a good job. I care about his character as a whole. You can tell he didn't mean for it to escalate to this. He really did care about her. He wanted to be with her. He was just kind of proud over what happened, you know, just kind of proud that he was able to do that without her knowing. But I am interested in seeing where his character's going to go. I liked him as a whole. The rest of the cast is fine. Like I said, just can't really comment on them right now because we just don't know a ton about them. But I will say, the actress that played Hannah's friend, Kat, was pretty bad, honestly. She was really the only character I wasn't a fan of. I thought her character was fine. I thought her acting was honestly pretty bad. I did not like her acting. I'm glad that she's not gonna be a big part of the show because she ends up leaving the show very quickly on, and I hope it stays away because I really did not like her. I thought that she was a very bad actress. I'm glad to see she's gone, though. As a whole, though, the rest of the cast is very good. I thought everyone did do a very good job. I'm interested in seeing where the rest of the cast goes throughout the show. Get to in the directing and the writing, because with a show as heavy as this, as much as the cast does matter, the atmosphere of the show also is very integral, and for the most part they got it down pretty well, I have to say. This is definitely, I wouldn't say it's a heavy show. Like, it's definitely a show that's easy to watch. I can definitely see it becoming harder to watch as time goes on, but it's definitely a somber show, and it's also very realistic. Like, I personally can't relate to it because I've never been through such a tragedy in high school. I've never really undergone something like that in high school, but I can say if something like this were to happen, this is a pretty accurate representation. It isn't trying to romanticize anything, it isn't trying to glorify anything. It's showing things as they probably would have happened, and I think they got that down pretty well here. And while the show definitely is quite somber, it does have its fun moments, but I wouldn't say it's obviously not a fun show, obviously because of, what it deals with and the topic and everything. It definitely does have its moments of enjoyment, but every moment of fun is very bittersweet because it is leading us closer and closer to Hannah's downfall, and the show already has me very riveted in that. And I think the writing here definitely complements that very nicely. I think the writing in general is very well done. The show isn't exactly a mystery series. It's more showing why someone would commit suicide, and it is definitely deriving from the book, which I'm happy with because I heard the book, a lot of it is kind of justifying suicide, and I didn't really see it as that. I saw it more as this show, at least so far, didn't seem to do that. Showing more, this is why she committed suicide, and this is what led her to do that sort of thing. And a lot of the things that some people might have thought were just mundane and little small things really have affected her over time. And just there were a lot of interesting things in the first episode. First, the re just like the reason why Hannah wanted to do it over cassette tapes. There's something so profound about her doing it over that. Just the idea that she wanted to keep it so it was private, and that way she could kind of protect anyone that she was kind of exposing and not trying to, get them to be held accountable for it, just kind of making them aware of what's going on, for anyone who wanted to know. Because remember, these tapes are like passed around to anyone. So I thought it was kind of cool the way she recorded it on a cassette tape because it was just too much for her to do on an MP4 file. I thought that was actually a really smart choice for the show to do. Like I said, shows how grounded the show is and how simple it really is. But it is definitely very hard. You can tell it's very much affecting Clay, and especially things between him and Hannah. Like I said, their friendship is definitely a complicated one because we see Clay after what happened with Justin, he's kind of dismissive towards her, and he wasn't dismissive towards her because he, was ashamed of what happened between her, on her dates. It was because of the fact that he was jealous of, it wasn't because of that. It was basically because he was jealous of her and Justin. He really liked her. He wanted to be with her. And now he's looking back on how the conversation went, and it's plagued him now. He's looked back at the conversation, and he's realizing that it kind of did lead to her downfall. And I'm very interested in seeing how that conversation really plays into the rest of the show, because you can already tell how things are going to go downhill for her, and how things are going to go to shits, and how things are probably just going to get worse and worse as they go on. And I thought they did a very good job with setting up that foundation, but not making it too overly cheesy. Like I said, I think that was definitely quite well done. There were a couple things here and there, like I said, a couple lines, just a couple exchange between Justin and Hannah where I just thought were a little bit too silly and just a little bit too cheesy to think about. Other than that, though, I thought the dialogue was fine. I thought for the most part, the dialogue was definitely very well done. It felt very much like high school, and I like that the show doesn't hold back. I like this TVMA. Few high school shows are. This show is, and I really did like the tone of the show. I think is definitely very well done. But the other thing that really I loved about the show that I really was not expecting was the cinematography. The cinematography is really cool, honestly. It does something that I really haven't seen done before. Where you have, well, I've definitely seen it done, but not quite in the way it's done here, where we'll see Hannah and Clay, they're having this conversation and things are in this one location, and we'll cut back and Clay is in that same location in the present, but Hannah's not there, and it's kind of showing what that can do, what someone can do without a person. I mean, it really brings home that idea of loss and grief and showing what that does, and just the smallest of things, like just a location that someone used to hang out at, what that is, what that, you know, how that's just not the same anymore, how a park is simply not the same, things like that, just little things here and there. I thought they handled very well. I think it's something the show already has down to a T. The way that he is remembering Hannah, the way he keeps picturing her, these different places, I think is very well done, and I think that really is going to be one of the highlights of the show, is just the way the show handles location. I think that's something that really, when someone dies, anyone remembers, oh, I was here with this person, or I remember this memory, I remember this. You know, when we see places, we don't just remember them as places, you remember them as memories or things that were of significance to us. And I think it was definitely a very good example of that, is the different sort of places that Clay would go. A lot of them, him and Hannah were at, and they had a very special meaning to him. And I thought that was definitely very well handled. So I really enjoyed that overall. I thought that definitely it was very sad, definitely, but it, like I said, really did bring home this tragedy quite well. It was definitely one of the most unique things, and most one of the things that stand out the most, definitely. If it's not for the cast, that's definitely one of the things that stand out the most. But as a whole, guys, I really enjoy this first episode. I think this was definitely very well done. I definitely mentioned seeing where the rest of the show is gonna go. I hope it doesn't go in a predictable route, because I feel like definitely we're gonna get more into these characters. We're gonna see who they really are. We're gonna see how they really affected Hannah's downfall. I'm into that story overall. It's crazy to say, I don't like saying that I'm looking forward to seeing someone commit suicide, because it's not that. It's just, it's heavy. It's very heavy material. But I definitely am interested in seeing what led her to that journey. What got her to, you know, that end of just not wanting to live anymore. What's gonna lead her to that, I think, is going to be very sad to watch. Definitely, but I think as a whole, it is definitely going to be a very interesting show to see where that really takes us. And I'm interested in seeing, you know, what really caused that downfall, and if this really does help Clay get a sense of closure, because you can tell he definitely does want that. But as a but overall, I really did enjoy his first episode, and I am going to give 13 Reasons Why Season 1, Episode 1, Tape 1, Side A 4 to 5 or a B plus. So we're guys, maybe this first episode, 13 Reasons Why. Now, from here on out, guys, I will not be reviewing every single episode. I'm just going to be reviewing the season or the series. I don't know if this is a mini series or a season. I know it's based off of one book, but I did hear they possibly set it for season 2, so we'll see if that actually does happen. Knowing Netflix, it probably will happen. Netflix rarely doesn't renew things, and I think they'll probably renew this as well. But overall, guys, I know you guys saw this first episode. I just, again, I don't, sorry I can't review the whole thing. I just don't really have time to binge things. You guys know I'm binging iZombie. I'm trying to review Iron Fist as much as I don't want to. I'd rather review the show, trust me. But Iron Fist, I know I have to review that show individually. I just can't not review that show individually. So I kind of, until I'm done with that, I can't really binge another show, because I'm binging two shows at once. And I am definitely going to continue to watch the show, though I will review the season whenever I finish it. But let me know what you guys thought of this first episode. Loved your thoughts. Did you like the way it handled its portrayal of suicide? Did you like the change from the book? If you are a fan of the book, did you like the performances? What do you think the romance between Hannah and I can't even think of his name now. Sorry, I'm blanking on his name right now. But did you think that relationship was as superficial as I kind of thought it was? But that's my review. Hope you guys enjoyed. We'll see you guys in my next video, which will be for a movie review, and we'll see you guys for that. Okay, bye.